record, my shit was number one, debuted all this shit. Then my second record did like half of that. And then by the time I got to my fourth record, I said, you know what? Fuck what a label telling me what to do. I'm gonna make shit that feel good to me and shit that I know that, you know, that they want for me. And it took on a different direction because it was like nobody could tell me what to do. And I was in control of it.
Period. That's my whole story. And that's why I keep doing this shit. Like, I could have definitely, I got some motherfucking bangers on here that sound like similar to what everybody else doing, you know, better.
But why? Why would you want to be in that same bracket to where a nigga got to figure out if this is you or if this is them or if this is him?
Nah, the thing is, I think if you're ever going to, like, not conform, but if you're ever going to do what other people do, like, do it better. Like, right. There's always an opportunity to raise the standard. Like, the first song on my EP is it's a trap song, technically, but it's the only song out of, what, seven that is a trap song. But the reason I did it, and the reason it's at the beginning and not throughout the entire project, is because I was like, from jump, let me let you know, I can do the trap shit. And better. My nigga, I don't take one breath. You see my Tiny Desk video? I don't take one breath in that first verse. Fucking lyrics down. Like, I can do what you do better than you live. And on top of that, I'm going to give you for the rest of this project the shit that I want to hear. The different shit that I feel. Like, the music of my soul, if you will. Like, I'm going to provide you with that. But I also think that there is going to be a time where I'm just like, I'm sick of the regular. Let me go ahead and, like, just anybody send me a beat real quick. And let me, like, scare people.
Let me give you a great scenario of what you're saying, which is similar to some of the shit I went through. It was a fucking auto-tune frenzy going on. Mm-hmm. T-Pain was fucking it up. T-Pain was killing it.
I was and just then, talking about that nigga. That is my
fault. Man, he was killing it. And then niggas started mimicking him, and everybody started doing it, and it started getting watered down, and they started pushing him to the back. So I got with a nigga from Atlanta, and I was like, you know what? Give me one of them things. But I'm going to put a twist on it. And the nigga gave me one. It was Sexual Eruption. And we put a little auto-tune and a lot of my voice. And that motherfucker fucked the game up. And it showed motherfuckers that I could do that. But when I do it, I'm going to do it with a different twist where I'm singing. I'm, you know, I'm sexy. I'm romantic. I'm on some other shit that you niggas can't do.
Period. That's it. Like, and that's why I do what I do. Like, that one song. For me to put one song on my EP that's a trap song. The other song that's, like, closest to it being a trap song, it's literally, like, it's not even the same fucking realm because it got an old-time sample on it, like, and on top of that, I flip my voice at the very end of the song to sound like a nigga because, like, when you hear it, you immediately, like, does she have Rick Ross on this song? But, like, it's literally me pitched all the way the fuck down saying the same shit, the same type, like, fervor that I was bringing to the verse before it. You're going to hear it again, but you're going to hear it from the voice of a nigga this time. Now, tell me I'm...
But you know what? That's your competitive nature to just say, like, you know what? I ain't going to do what y'all do, but let me fuck y'all up real quick. If y'all ever try to question me on this shit that y'all do, that's so easy. I could do this shit so easy.
Like, it is. And I be trying to, like, remain humble. Remain humble because it's not like a humility thing. It's more so like knowing your worth and knowing what you like, what your power is, what you bring into the game. And I don't think that what I bring anybody else right now is bringing.
This culture of hip hop, because you're a part of hip hop culture, was built on the competitive nature of I'm better than you. Mm-hmm. And I'm better than you don't mean I hate you. It means that, damn, your song is so dope. We gonna make one just as dope, if not doper. And we're going to celebrate each other at the end of the day because we both made dope music.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. People forget that competitive nature and they don't want you to say certain shit because at like my level, motherfuckers be like, oh, you're not humble if I say that I'm the best. If I say that
fuck I... That. Say like, that shit, mean that shit. I came out the door telling motherfuckers they don't want none. What's happening?
You don't want no smoke. You ain't want
what's
smoke.
What's happening?
I'm 23 now, nigga. You don't want
what's none. Happening?
On my best day.
Now...
First day you don't want shit, but
now what's happening? I do this shit.
Yeah, that's where I'm at. That's where I'm at mentally. So I'm like working on shit like that, working on shit that make me feel that way and reinstates that because we're so used to the normal shit, the regular status quo shit. Not the shit on anybody's art, of course, but like we're so fucking used to it. You know what I mean? Like we eat it up because our ears are conditioned to, not because it's actually like, you know, making you feel anything different than what the last one did. No shade to anyone, of course.
Change the game, baby. You doing your thing, and I just wanted to commend you and let you know that and get on a level with you so you can hear it directly from me. I fuck with you. I love you. Keep doing your shit. Keep innovating, motivating, and dominating.
Thank you so much, Unc. Like, I appreciate that. We got to get in, and I'm going to make you this country song, so don't fucking challenge me again.
Get at me. DM me, and I'll give you my line where you get a direct connect. And if you ever, ever in the city of Inglewood, pull up to my motherfucking spot, and I'm going to drape you and dress you.
I'm so close, nigga. I'll be there tomorrow. Like, what the fuck? But anyway, I got you. Say less.
Don't say, and I'm going to say this to you, and take this for the right way. You remind me so much of my motherfucking daughter.
Oh, what is that? Let me hear it.
I swear to God, like, your tone, your temperament, your conversation, the way you carry yourself, all that shit. Y'all look like twins.
We here.
You hear me?
I accept. At this point, I'm just going to call myself your daughter.
You so. Better know it. You better know it. And I'm going to act accordingly.
I'm going to be like, what's up, Dad? I'm not calling. Other niggas can call you that. Like, whatever. Nah.
Yeah, keep on banging out, though. Keep making that hot shit until we meet again. Stay blessed.
Of course. You have a good one.
Love you.
So, love you, too. Wow. So, that happened. I was just on here talking shit and being stupid, and now Snoop just came and just blessed my life. Is that what we do? We just pop up a nigga's shit and bless their life? Okay.